हेलो बच्चों, हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू ऑल आर गुड। नाउ इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर इन आवर कार्बन एंड इट्स कंपाउंड वी सॉ डायमंड। ओके, सो इन दैट डायमंड वी सॉ स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ डायमंड, अरेंजमेंट ऑफ डायमंड। ओके, नाउ इट्स टाइम टू डिस्कस, ओके, व्हाट इज द यूजेस ऑफ डायमंड्स। ओके, सो वी विल स्टार्ट नाउ हियर यूजेस। ओके, व्हाट एवर यूजेस ऑफ डायमंड्स। Okay, so see here, uses of diamonds. Okay, so basically whatever uses of your diamonds. Okay, so see here, whatever uses of diamonds. First use, whatever use, okay, your diamonds is used in jewelries. So how we can, why they are used in jewelry? Because it has a property to reflect and refract light. What better that property? Property. It has ability. It has ability to reflect and refract light. Okay, it has the ability to reflect and refract light. Okay, so second, if you are considering, okay, so second use, diamonds are used in cutting and drilling rocks. Okay, so see here, like that, so much important here, whatever diamond use next, it has extraordinary sensitivity. Okay, so how we can say it has extraordinary sensitivity to heat rays, and due to this reason it is used for making high precision thermometer. Okay, because it has a high what we can say extraordinary sensitivity towards the heating rays. Okay, or we can say heat rays. Therefore, whatever diamonds are used for what? For making high precision, for making high precision thermometer. Okay, high precision thermometers. Okay, so see here, fourth one, whatever fourth use of this diamond has ability to cut out harmful radiation, and due to this reason, whatever these diamonds, okay, it for making protective windows in robotic spacecraft. Okay, so see here, due to this reason, it is used for making protective windows for space probes, or that space probes, what we can write here? Yes, robotic space craft. Okay, so now we will discuss here whatever fifth one. Okay, so see here, fifth use, diamond dyes are used for drawing thin wires. Okay, one of the important this thing, diamond dyes. So see here, diamond dyes is used for making or used for withdrawing drawing used for drawing thin wires. Okay, so how much important it is here, thin wires. So it much very thin wire we can withdraw of diameter less than 1/6 of the diameter of human hair. Okay, 1/6 diameter of that human hair. Okay, now that much thin wire we can draw with the help of this diamond dyes. Okay, we draw thin wires. How much thin? 1/6 of the diameter of human hair. Okay, so this important you have to write in your notebook uses. So six use. Okay, so as you know, surgeons, okay, in surgery, okay, in case of a delicate operation, whatever diamond knives, okay, what we can say here, diamond knives we can use. Okay, in diamond knives we can use in delicate operations. Okay, like that, so much important use of this all. Okay, uses of diamonds. Now we will discuss here whatever our next part, graphite. Okay, so concentrate beta here. These are what simple uses of your diamonds. Now we will see what beta here. Yes, graphite. So say here, graphite is what? Okay, so we will start here. What is your graphite? So see, basically graphite is what? Is a grayish black substance, okay, which occur in the earth crust in free state, but it can also be prepared artificially. Whatever your graphite, we can also prepare artificially from carbon in an electric furnace. From carbon in an electric furnace at 273 to how much temperature? 2773 Kelvin in an electric furnace. Okay, now see, whatever graphite melting point is, graphite melting point is 43. How much beta here? 4300 Kelvin. Okay, so these are basic information of your graphite. So now we will discuss how we can prepare whatever graphite in artificially in electric furnace. So see here, your carbon plus SiO2 silica. Okay, so when you heat this, so basically what you will get? Yes, you will get what? SiC. Okay, we can call this SiC is what? Yes beta, silicon carbide. What we can call this? Silicon carbide. Okay, or we can write whatever another name for this SiC, carborundum. What beta here? Carborundum. Okay, so when you heat at 2500 degrees Celsius, okay, so then you will get what beta? Carbon plus silicon. So beta, this carbon is what your? Yes, graphite. You will get artificially in electric furnace. Where beta? In electric furnace you will get. Understood? So these are what here? Yes, these are what your preparation of artificial preparation of your graphite. So now we will discuss your structure. Okay, how it looks, whatever your graphite. So that also we will discuss. Crystal of graphite, how we can draw. Okay, it consists basically sheets or layers of carbon atoms. Okay, so see here, I am drawing here whatever your graphite. So as like this. Okay, first hexagon type structures in that. Okay, so one hexagon over. Now see here, second hexagon like this. Okay, so thereafter here like this your hexagon. Now see here. Okay, so these are what basically flat sheet like a structure, whatever you are. Yes, whatever your graphite. Okay, so then after that, say here also downward also we have to draw like this. So see here how we can how we have to draw here, see like this. Yes, okay. Now next one. Now what beta here, next one. Okay, okay. Now whatever basic information here, very much important. Okay, so say here. Okay, so like that. Okay, flat sheet here. Okay, so like that here. Okay, are you observing? Yes, so see here, like that we have to do arrangement. Okay, see here. Understood? Like that. These are what? Flat sheet. Okay. So basically, see here, it looks like this, whatever your graphite. So it has, so say here, how whatever carbon atoms arrangement here important. Okay, it's look like your graphite sheets. Okay, so see each carbon atom. Okay, so we will now discuss here how it will arrange. So say here, we will write here each carbon atom. Okay, so each carbon in the layer of hexagon, each carbon in the layer of hexagon. Okay, each carbon in the layer of hexagonal ring is attached to, okay, it is attached to three other carbon atoms. By strong covalent bond. Okay, understood? So whatever these bonds is joined by what? Strong covalent bond. Okay, this each and every one. Okay, now see here, these are empty spaces, what we can call this. Okay, so see here, we can write like this. Okay, so see, weak van der Waal forces of attraction, whatever in middle space, we call it as a what? Yes, weak van der Waal. Yes, weak van der Waal forces of attraction. Okay, beta, this weak van der Waal force, we heard in this weak van der Waal force of attraction in? Yes, in one of the in periodic classification of elements, van der Waal radius. So whatever that radius between the two atoms in non-bonded state. So see here, in non-bonded state means here empty space. Okay, so we call it as a what? Which force is present in this empty space? Weak van der Waal forces of attraction, or basically we can call it as a what? Weak forces. Okay, so these are what? Your graphite structure having we can write here in bond length also here. So see here, bond length as like this. See this bond length. Okay, so I'm say this bond length 141.5 picometer. Okay, understood. Now here, whatever this bond length, okay, so see here, this bond length, okay, so or we can say this distance 340 picometer. Okay, so these are what basically your structure of what? Graphite. Understood. Okay, now we'll discuss some theoretical part also on the basis of your graphite. So ready? Okay, see here. Beta, as you know, whatever each carbon is bonded strongly strongly by covalent bonds. Okay, now we'll discuss here. Whatever they are making hexagonal rings. Okay, so one of the important here that you have to also mention. So see here, each carbon atom, so say we have to write this, each carbon atom in hexagonal ring, makes three single bond. Yes, makes three single bond. Okay, makes how much? Three single bond as shown in figure. We saw this figure also, three single covalent bond, or we can say bond, and fourth electron, as you observe in your diagram, fourth electron for a partial double bond with all carbon atom. The fourth electron is delocalized. So whatever like that situation arises. So see here, like that situation, as you know, we discuss like this. Okay, this fourth electron. Okay, understood. So this fourth electron. So see here, each carbon atom in hexagonal ring makes three single covalent bond and fourth electron form a partial double bond character with all carbon atoms. With how much? With all carbon atoms. Okay. So whatever that fourth electron is delocalized over. So see here. The fourth electron is delocalized. Delocalized means what? जो अस्थिर है वो स्थिर नहीं है. ओके, द फोर्थ इलेक्ट्रॉन इज डीलोकलाइज ओवर द होल शीट. ओके, सो दिस मच ऑल्सो वेरी मच इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग. एंड ड्यू टू दिस मोबाइल इलेक्ट्रॉन okay, graphite conducts, and due to this mobile electrons, graphite conduct electricity. Okay, now you got this answer, why your graphite conduct electricity, other they are not whatever allotropes of carbon, they not conduct electricity, or we can say what? Poor conductor of electricity. Okay, so this reason. Now only we saw structure also. Okay, now we will discuss here properties of graphite. Okay, so we will discuss what properties of graphite. Okay, so see here, in properties of graphite. So see, in properties of graphite, first, it is relatively soft and greasy because it's hexagonal layer structure. It is what? Relatively soft and greasy. So why it is soft and greasy? Because of, yes, because of hexagonal rings. Okay, hexagonal rings or hexagonal layers are present in your graphite. So see here, second, it has a metallic luster. It has what? Metallic luster. Okay, some like chakaki. Okay, we call it in Marathi. Okay, so see third, it's opaque. Yes, it is opaque. Understood. Now see what are fourth. Yes, density of graphite is very strong. So see what, how much density of graphite is very strong? 2.25 grams per cm cube. Grams per cm cube. Now see fifth, melting point. Okay, melting point, we discuss melting point also, that you have to write. Understood. Okay, so these are what beta properties of graphite. Now see here, after properties you have to discuss use of graphite. What beta? Yes, uses of graphite. So see here, in uses of graphite, so basically your graphite is used to make electrode for electrolytic cells. It is used for making electrodes in where? Electrolytic cells. Okay, so and second see here, soft and greasy. You know it is a soft and greasy, so we can take benefit of that soft and greasy nature of graphite. Therefore it is used as a lubricant in all machine parts. Okay, in all machine parts. Okay, and one more, it has a good high melting point. Therefore it can act as a good lubricating agent. Okay, understood. So it is also remarkable whatever use of this graphite. Now third we will discuss here, graphite is also used to moderate whatever as you know, in atomic power station they are generating what? Electricity. Okay, so graphite is used to moderate. It is used to moderate. Yes, moderate speed of what? Speed of fast moving neutrons. Okay, in a nuclear reactor. In a. Yes, beta. In a nuclear reactor. Okay, whenever production of electricity was done. Okay, fourth most important use of this graphite. Okay, so when you are this graphite, it will mix with clay. Okay, mix with wax and clay. So graphite is used for making core of lead pencil. Okay, and it gives what? Mark on that paper. Understood. Okay, which color? Sometimes it is a black in color lead pencil we are using. Okay, so therefore often whatever the graphite, we call it as a what? Black. What beta? Black lead. Or we can call it with this name, Plumbago. Okay, so you have to keep in mind all these things regarding what? Regarding your this graphite. Okay, so Now we'll discuss here whatever next part. After we saw diamond, then we saw graphite. Okay, so now we are going to discuss fullerenes. So we will discuss within a short time.